Hi everyone, welcome back to Business Studies class. Today we'll start with a new chapter, fifth chapter, that is organizing. In chapter 1 we have seen that a manager will perform 5 important functions, isn't it? First one is planning and second is organizing. So we are here with a chapter called organizing. In the same first chapter we have seen the meaning of all the functions. There we have learned something, just meaning of organizing, isn't it? So, in this chapter, you will be learning what is this organizing in detail. Because one of the limitation of planning says that planning alone does not give you success. As you have come out with a good plan, but if you are unable to implement the plan, if you start implementing the plan, your organizing becomes necessary. Because up to implementation, that is setting an objective, having some planning premises, then identifying the alternatives, choosing the right alternative, analyzing the alternatives and then choosing the right alternative, all these, it is a mental exercise. Literally, you are not doing anything, you are just thinking about that in the planning. So when you come to the step of implementation of plan, that is the starting where actually your thoughts will be converted into deeds. There your organizing function starts. In order to implement the plan, we need many things. For an example, we have taken when we have started planning chapter, when we have studied the planning chapter, there we have taken some example like you have to plan your tomorrow's travel. Tomorrow you want to travel somewhere, so you want to start planning about that. So you have planned everything. Now you have to start with the step called implementation of plan. In order to implement the plan, you need all those things what you have imagined in your thoughts. For example, in planning you have decided, you have planned that tomorrow I have to go through go to a particular place and I have to travel through the four-wheeler, you have decided, isn't it? So that was the mental exercise. You thought about that, but when you want to implement the plan, now you have to arrange four-wheeler for you. If you have your own, make it ready. See whether that is in right condition or not. If it is not available with you, you have to hire it. Like this, many options you have. So when you start implementing, your organizing function starts. What the meaning of organizing we have seen in chapter 1? That is arranging everything to the organization in order to move with the plan. Organizing in the sense, arranging everything as per plan. So initially I have planned, that is the first function. Then second function is, you start arrange everything which is necessary to implement your plan. So in this chapter, this is a basic meaning of organizing what we have seen in chapter 1. But in this chapter, when we get into the chapter, you will be seeing in depth meaning. Many other things also involved in organizing apart from arranging. That we are going to see in this particular chapter. Let us start with the meaning. So here, you can write the same thing for meaning or definition, but the only thing is, whenever definition is asked as a question, so you have to define what is organizing, means you have to write the meaning of organizing according to some author. Someone has given some meaning, for example, about a particular student, my opinion will be different, some other lecturer's opinion will be different. So when definition is asked, we have to particularly mention according to this particular person, this is the fact. According to this particular person, this is the fact. Like this, you have to start defining the things. So never forget that if definition is asked, I'm repeating it very often. Because many students, even after saying that, write an assignment like define planning when I asked, many have written without the author name. So I'm repeating once again, don't commit that mistake. See, you will be losing marks there. So whenever definition is asked, you have to write meaning of that particular word or concept according to someone. So here we can see definition or meaning. It is according to Louis A. Allen, a management expert. According to Allen, organizing is a process. First, remember, organizing is a process. We say organizing is a function. Yes, organizing is a function and it is a process too. Why we call it as a process is it includes many things. It does not include only one act. It includes multiple tasks. When I say organizing, it includes multiple tasks. Hence, we say it is a process. If you remember, in first year, we have seen classification of industry. There we have seen processing industry. There, why we call such industries as processing industry is a particular raw material, a same raw material will move through different processing stages. Hence, we call such industries as processing industries. Similarly, when a manager, in order to organize, when he takes several steps, when he does several tasks, it is called a process. So, we say organizing is not a single task, it is a combination of many tasks. Hence, it is a process. Okay? So, organizing is a process of identifying and grouping the work to be performed. You please concentrate over here. Organizing is a process of identifying and grouping the work to be done. Okay? So, when I start implementing the plan, when I start to do the plan as per my planning, initially what I have to do is what exactly I have to do, what work I have to do, that you have to identify. For example, same example we'll consider. You have mentally prepared how you have to go, what all the things you need, where you want to go, whom you want to meet, and what gifts you want to give to them. Everything you have planned yesterday itself. So your plan is ready. And we know that only if you plan, you will not get success. You have to implement the plan. That is, you have to start working as per your plan. Okay? That is what your implementation part. As I said, when you start implementing, your organizing function starts. So, in organizing, what I'll do, initially I have to identify what exactly I have to do. For example, the same example if we take, I have to call and inform that I am meeting you tomorrow. That is, I will be coming to your home tomorrow to where you are going. That particular person you have to inform. Okay, you have to call and inform. Then you, if you don't have a vehicle, you have to call some service and you have to ask them to provide you vehicle. And like this, you need communicating. For many other things, you need communicating to some other persons. This is one type of work. Then you have you need some eatables which you may in need of in your traveling. So you have to go to market and you have to purchase all those things which are necessary, mainly if you consider eatables. Okay, and even you want to give some gift to those people whom you are going to meet. So for that also you have to go to the market. Okay, like this you start identifying the work, what all the things I have to do now. Okay, when I start implementing the plan, I have to identify what all the different things I have to do. Once you identify the work, start grouping the similar works. For example, I told you have to call your that particular person whom you are going to meet. That is, you have to involve in communication. Even you have to call to the cab service. That is also communication. So, these two communication, you make it as communication. Part 1, that is grouping. And then purchasing. You need some eatables in your travel and also you need something gifts which you want to present. For both you have to go to market and purchase. So purchase, you group it, some other group. Like this, you have to group your works. For example, I have identified 10 works to be done. Okay. See that in 10 works, you can make some grouping if they are similar. For example, for eatables and also for gifts, I have to go to the market and I have to purchase. So, I'll make them as one group. And in identifying the work, okay, even you have identified 10 works, in that, if you have similar works, you just group them as one. As I said, purchase is one, communication is one, cleaning up is one, like this. Like this, if you identify and grouping the work, that becomes a first task of your organizing. Then comes defining and delegating responsibility and authority. The words responsibility and authority you might be familiar with. because this we have seen as one of the principle in our chapter 2, that is principles of management. There what you have learned? Whenever you give some responsibility, what is this responsibility? Responsibility is a situation where you have to you have to do something and you have to report to your superiors, right? And authority is a power of giving order, isn't it? So we have seen this responsibility and authority. Wherever responsibility is there, you have to give them some authority. And wherever authority is there, generally you have to feel responsible towards that. That is what we have learned as one of the principle, isn't it? So in organizing, define and delegate responsibility and authority. See, I have identified work and I have grouped the similar works. Overall 10 works I have, but I have grouped 2 as 1. So I have only 5 works to be done now. Okay, but in each group I have 2 tasks. Okay, if communication is one group, so in communication I have to call two people. In purchasing I have two things to purchase. Like this I have grouped my activities. So now I have only 5. Now define and delegate, in the sense you have to see all the things you may not able to do. So for example, you have to go to a market, you have to get everything, you have to clean the things, and you have to call everyone and inform. It becomes you may not have so much of time to do all the tasks. Hence some task you delegate to someone, that is some task you give to someone to do. That is what giving responsibility. For example, two are moving tomorrow. Okay, you and your brother or you and your friend are moving today, tomorrow. Okay, so what you can do is two group of work you can carry out, and other two types of work you can give to your friend. That is what delegating. Delegating responsibility and authority, in the sense giving some power and responsibility to someone to do that work, because everything cannot be done by you alone. If you keep on doing everything, generally what happens, your time will be wasted, your energy will be wasted, you will be tired. Is it clear? Hence when you have more things to do, generally delegate the things. That is, you just make it into parts and give to the someone who is able of doing that. And even define what they have to do in exact. For example, me and my friend, tomorrow we are moving. So, 3 works I have kept for myself, I have to do, and 2 I have delegated to my friend. Clearly, I have to say them, I have to define them what they have to do in exact, and what is their responsibility and what is their authority. For example, when you give the task to your friend, you can say them, if it is a small correction, you can make it out. If it is a big issue, then you come to me. Some sort of authority you give to them. For example, cleaning up the car, you have to clean the car also. Okay, tomorrow you are moving through car, so you want to clean up your car. So that authority, that responsibility, initially you give to the cab driver and say him, if it is a small thing, any small repairs are there, you just go for a test drive, and if you have any small repairs, you just make it out. No need of taking my concern if it is a small issue. If it is a big issue which involves more money, then you contact me. If not, okay. In that way, you have to clearly define what is your responsibility and what is your authority. Is that clear? First one in organizing, the first task is identify the work and group the similar work to be done. Then define and delegate. Correctly, you say what to be done and who has to do that. And next, establishing relationship for the purpose of enabling people to work most effectively together in accomplishing objective. We know that in an organization, it is a teamwork. It is not a single person who will be working for an organization. Many will be involved in the things, isn't it? So here, many will be there. So people will get confused to whom I have to give order, and subordinates, many will be confused from whom I have to receive the order. See, if you remember, we have seen unity of command, one of the principle. There we have learned that every subordinate should have a single boss. For example, I am working as in a particular department, I am working as a subordinate. So there should be only a single boss to me from whom I have to receive orders and to whom I have to give a response. If I don't know that from whom I have to receive order and to whom I have to give my accountability, generally I'll get confused with this. If I have more bosses, for example, single subordinate have 5 boss, all the 5 will give start giving orders to me, and I may not have right time to do all the works, then what happens? My efficiency decreases. Mentally, I will be disturbed. Are you getting that? Hence, after defining and delegating their authority and responsibility, every manager has to establish relationship. What type of relationship it is? It is superior and subordinate relationship has to be established by a manager. Every subordinate should know who is my superior, and every superior should know who are my subordinates. If such things happens, what happens? I will be knowing to whom I have to give orders, and they will be knowing to whom they are accountable. Say for example, you have two departments, purchase department and marketing department. In all the three departments, two subordinates and one superior is having. Then what happens? For example, we'll take A and B. A is the head of purchase department and B is the head of marketing department. So A will be having subordinates and B will also have subordinates. And now A's subordinates are not accountable to the B. Is it clear? Similarly, B's subordinates are not accountable to A. They are individual. So, A is a superior and he has two subordinates. So, A has to give orders to those two subordinates, and these two subordinates are accountable to A. In this way, the relationship has to be established by a manager. If it is not done, more bossism will develop. Subordinates will get confused and the work may not be done in a right manner. So these three tasks we have to remember when organizing is asked. So clearly try to understand, organizing is a process of initially identifying the work and group the similar work, then define and delegate authority and responsibility, and then establish a relationship. Why I am doing all these things? Why I am identifying? Why I am grouping the similar activities? Why I am defining and delegating authority and responsibility? And why I am establishing relationship is to attain the organizational objectives efficiently. That is the ultimate goal. That is the ultimate goal of any manager. Okay? So, the same thing we can see in our process. Okay? As I said, organizing is a process. These are the steps. So, if you remember these steps, it becomes easy to remember the definition. So, almost 2 marks, for 2 marks, definition is asked. So, you should be clear with this. And this chart, along with this chart, it can be asked for 4 marks. If you understand the meaning or if you understand the process in a right manner, you are able to score good marks. So, this can be asked for 4 marks and your meaning or definition can be asked for 2 marks. The same thing is presented through chart here. This is steps in organizing process. I said organizing is a process as it involves multiple tasks. Okay. Now these are the steps. The same thing what we have seen in the meaning. Okay. Identifying and division of work. Identifying and division of work. Division of work, you remember, I hope, one of the principle of management. Right. So what is this division of work? Entire work you make into small units and allot to the right person. When a particular work is allotted to a particular person on regular basis, that particular person becomes efficient in his works. That is, he becomes expert. Generally, when he is expert, his confidence levels increases, his efficiency increases. Even he may gain monetary benefit also, because when you are expert in that, you will be promoted to the higher positions where your monetary benefits will be increased. Isn't it? Hence, first identify the work and divide the work. Then departmentalization. Departmentalization is nothing but you are grouping the similar activities, right? So group the similar activities into one department. And then assignment of duties, that is authority and responsibility. What we have studied is the same. Assign the duties, that is assign the responsibility. And whenever you give them responsibility, even give them authority, right? And then start establishing reporting relationship. Reporting relationship is the sense superior and subordinate relationships, because every subordinate is responsible or he is accountable to his superior. That is what your reporting relationship. So all the 4 steps are very easy to remember in this way. You can remember in this way, or else you can go with the meaning. I hope you are getting the things. If you remember any one also, you will be able to write the meaning and definition very easily. So go through that. This chart is very important. In next class, we'll go with the detailed information. थैंक यू.